welcome to the Lenten service. You all right?
No, there's no camera up there. Keep going.
All right. I'll keep going then. As the song said, no scheme of man can take me from the hand of Christ. Isn't that wonderful to know? Especially in times like today. Once again, I want to welcome you to the first day of Lent, Ash Wednesday. What a fantastic time of the year it really is, if you think about it. Because if it hadn't been for that Easter Sunday, the world would still be lost, and we would have no redemption. Let's pray, please. Dear Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for sending your Son to this earth to walk next to us, to learn what it's like to have to live in our shoes. But Lord, we also know that he came here to save us because he knew that we did not have the grace and the power to be in heaven with you someday. So he came here willingly just to lay down his life for us. And for this, we will ever be grateful. And Lord, we cannot let anything that's happening in this world today, regardless of whether it's in the United States, Israel, or any other country, Lord, as long as we turn back to you, we will be a saved nation. We will be a saved people. And Lord, we know it is your will to have as many of us return to you because, Lord, we are your children and you are our Father. Lord, we want to thank you for this time together. And Lord, we just want to praise you for everything that you do for us each and every day of our lives. And Lord, we just ask that this service go, go easily and that everything turns out the way we would like it to. And that through this whole service, we do honor and glorify you in everything that we do. These prayers we ask in your name. Amen.
Of Jesus, I fain would make my stand. The shadow of the mighty rock within a weary land, a home within the burning of the noontide heat and the burden of the day. Upon that cross of Jesus, mine eyes at times can see the very suffered there for me, and from my lifted heart with tears to wonders I confess the one. sunshine of his face. Content to let the world go by, to know no gain or loss. My sinful self, my only shame,
suffered willingly. Responsive reading 230. I am the good shepherd. Lays down his life. I have not been rebellious. I have not drawn back. I did not hide my face from mocking and spitting. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shears is silent, so he did not open his mouth. When he suffered, he made no threats. Instead, he entrusted himself to him who judges justly. I am the good shepherd. Do you think I cannot call on my Father, and he will at once put at my disposal more than 12 legions of angels? No one takes my life from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I read that wrong. I'm so sorry. That's what it is when you can't see. Do you think I cannot call on my Father? We already went through this. Chuck threw me off. I'm sorry. Okay, the one I can read to you is, it says John 10:11. The other ones, I'm sorry, I cannot see. Even with these glasses on, I can't see. I'm sorry, can somebody help me with this? Well, one thing I just found out, I need to go see the eye doctor again.
We're going to give our tithes and offerings now. So thank you for being generous with your heart and with your pocket.
Thank you. That's not me.
We have another responsive reading, Ministry in the Spirit. Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news about him spread through the whole countryside. He went to Nazareth, and on the Sabbath day he stood up to read. The scroll of the prophet Isaiah was handed to him.
The Spirit of the Lord is on me, because he has anointed me to preach good news.
He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners.
Recovery of sight for the blind.
To release the oppressed.
To proclaim the year of the Lord's favor.
The eyes of everyone in the synagogue were fastened on him, and he began by saying to them,
Today the scripture is fulfilled in your hearing.
All spoke well of him.
They were amazed at the gracious words that came from his lips.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God, our loving Father, we all have come before you at this time in commemoration of the day that is setting us apart for repentance, declaring ourselves with all our weakness that we got the victory in Christ. And Father, we come before you this time, lifting up all the needs of our community. We pray for those who are sick, that God, you may touch them, and you may wake them up from their bed so that they can be able to walk. And we pray for those who are grieving, that God, you will be a shoulder where they can lean for hope. We pray for those who are traveling, that you grant them journey mercies, remembering Pastor Joe and Judy, that Lord, you may protect them and you may guide them and set that time that they will be traveling back home safely, with all those who will be traveling across the country and overseas. And we pray for this country, that Lord, you may hold the United States of America in your hand. Despite the fact that we have gone astray like a lost sheep, you will bring us close unto you. Hear us, O good Lord, as we continue to worship. May your Holy Spirit continue to lead us in this congregation. Those who are at home, remembering those members of the community of our church that are not being able to be here with reasons. Especially at this time, I want to remember Frank, and I also want to remember Meredith, and I want to remember Carol, and I want to remember all the rest of the other people that even I don't know how to mention them one by one. But Lord, you know them more than I do. Reach out with your Holy Spirit to bring healing into their lives. Lead us as we continue to hear your word. We ask you all this. Through Christ our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ we pray. Amen.
Go ahead and stand with me, please.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay. despised by the world, has a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it to dark Calvary. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown.
To the
old rugged cross I will ever be true. It's shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. And exchange it someday for a crown.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. I am delighted to be here tonight speaking the word of the Lord. But it is not always easy to speak the holy word of Christ, especially on such a day. Many, many people will ask themselves, what is the Ash Wednesday all about? And some of my other friends, when I told them that today is the Ash Wednesday, and people started asking me all kind of different questions. What is it all about? Oh no, it is not. Christians cannot celebrate this. It is something for Catholics, or it is something like this. So people started kind of having a lot of debate. But my response to them will be soon in the scripture. But I wanted to begin saying that, remember, you are dust. Remember that you are dust. And to the dust you shall return. So if you know that you are dust, so the answer is that you are dust and you will return to dust. That helps clarification of What is the Ash Wednesday all about? Because we are all from the dust, and we are going to return to the dust. But as Wednesday was marked as the beginning of the Lent, this is the season that begins with the dash, with the dust, and the ash, and it was found in the ancient tradition, of the church, that it symbolizes the humility before God. So when we talk about this day, it is the time that we are humbling ourselves before God. And it is the time that we see ourselves truly as we reflect on our attitude and our actions and our priorities, and to return to God for repentance and prayer. We set aside all our personal gains, and we set ourselves special, coming to the throne of glory to repent and confess in all our attitudes and in all our actions and in all our ways of life. And then in this day, it is the beginning of 40 days of the journey. It is marking the 40 days of the fasting. And if you begin today, count it from today up to the time when Jesus was entering Jerusalem. This is a 40 days when Jesus was entering into the triumph, into the temple, to Jerusalem. So within this period of time, it is a journey that we reflect our darkness, that we come out of our darkness and we seek for restoration. And we seek for the light. We also come out from our fear to love, from our mourning to celebration, and from ashes to joy. In one of the readings that I wanted to reflect on today is from the book of the minor prophet, Joel. Joel proclaims that, "Yet even now, says the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with the fasting and with the weeping, and with the mourning, rend your heart and not your clothing. Return to the Lord, your God, for he is gracious and he is merciful, slow to anger, abounding in steadfast love." You can find this from Joel chapter 2, verse 12-13. So Lent is all about returning to God, brothers and sisters. When we talk, when we reflect about the Lent, the season of the Lent, it is a time that we are returning to God. It is a time of returning to God. It is time of confession. And God desires us to be in a relationship with him. God is calling you tonight to be in a relationship with him. Are you feeling a distance or disconnected from God? If you are feeling disconnected from God, this is the time that you come close to God. Are you close to him as you want to be, you want him to be close to you? Do you need to draw closer to God? Do you need to return to God within in this season of the Lent? Do you want to return to him at this time? This Lent, God is inviting you, or inviting us, to come home to feast with him, to receive his restoration and his grace, to feel his loving and compassion that he embraces in Christ. The choice is yours tonight. How are you going to spend the next 40 days from today? How are you going to spend? Are we going to turn and set these 40 days? Not only these 40 days that we are fasting and confessing, but these 40 days should reflect our life continuously. It should not be just a season. It should be continuously we reflect coming close to God. May these Ash Wednesday services tonight be a help for you, to guide you in your journey, to give you direction. May this Ash Wednesday today be like your GPS to guide you. Ash Wednesday, it tells us that we should remember that we are from the dust, and to the dust we shall return. And these moving words, which we will soon hear, is all about coming from the soul, not coming from our own body, but coming from the soul close to thee. This forces us to confront our humanity and our morality. When we talk about this Lent season, it is a time that we test ourselves. It is the time that we purify ourselves. It is the time that we set ourselves apart. It is the time that we sanctify ourselves. In a few minutes, many of us will receive, like when you go to some other churches, what I wanted to say is, like in other churches, they actually take the symbol of the ash and then they put it on their head. And it doesn't matter, because they just put that as a mark on their face, just as a symbol, like when we are immersed in the water during the time of the baptism, or when we have the sprinkle of the water. You don't need to worry about the tradition of each and every church, but it is just a symbol. Take it as a symbol, but the most important part of it is repentance and returning to the Lord. So, when we look into the physical mark of our foreheads, but this is just a temporal. That's what I'm saying. When we see the mark on the faces of the people with the ash, it is just temporal. It should not be there, but think about what is important here. The line through which the land, for many of us, they bring back the painful memories of the loss. I won't tell you this. When I'm talking about, this is a very crucial time. Usually when you go to the funeral, at the funeral, at the ending, committing our loved one to God, there is always words that you hear from the priest or from the pastor. They say, earth to earth, ash to ash, dust to dust. So always when I hear this, my voice crack each and every time I say these words at the funeral, because, you know, I do say these words, especially I'm telling you this, this is what I do. And always when I'm telling you, my heart and my voice cracks, because it's not easy to say this. Living nowhere to hide behind, nothing can lessen the roar of that line, because it is a mark that you are saying this person is already, when you're saying dust to dust or ash to ash, you are saying that this body is returning to the ground. But let us turn not the ending. I won't say this, because when I say that is the ending of the service, when it is say from earth to earth, from soil to soil, from dust to dust. But let us not turn to the ending, but to the beginning. Dust, we are dust. In the second creation, according to the account in Genesis, God forms man from the dust of the ground, and he breathed into their nostrils the breath of life. So think about this. From the dust, there is a life that God breathed, that life from him to man. And the man became a living being. And from the man's rib, God created Eve as his partner, which is a story that you all know about it. But let's go to this. We all know about this story. And there is always a blame. Like at the serpent's suggestion, the woman breaks God's only commandment and eats the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil and share it with the man. So there is a problem. The problem started now, blame. Man, you see, the devil have started. So now the serpent has convinced Eve, and Eve has taken the fruit and gave it to her husband, and also the husband that he did not say no. He accepted. Had he to say no, probably the curse would have not come to our life. But he accepted it. Then the man, now, when God came in the garden and he asked, Adam, where are you? He responded that he is naked. Did he ask you whether you are wearing something or not? No. It is because he was trying to run away from the problem. Now, the blame started. The man blames the woman, and the woman blames the serpent. But God holds the three of them accountable. God did not say anything to only one of them. All of you, because you have done this, you are all accounted for. You are accountable for all what you have done. The woman suffers pain. Sorry. The serpent, okay, know that all of you, three of you, not just a woman. Number one, the serpent must crawl on its belly and eat the dust. That is the dust where we came from. Now the curse has been given to the serpent to eat from the dust. That is number one. The woman suffers pain during the childbearing. And I know Elisa is soon going to feel that pain. Amen. But it is because that is the process. That is the process of giving the child out. But that is coming from, you know, all of us, we are born through that pain. Through that pain. And then for the man, crush the ground because of you. You have to work. You know, I know men, it is tough sometimes. Because we are the head of the family, and sometimes we don't sleep. And sometimes we work hard jobs. Some people work two jobs. It's because of the curse. We want to provide a meal to the hands of 2 to 3, 5 mouths because of that curse. By the sweat of your face, you shall eat the bread until you return to the ground. We are cursed with that curse that we will eat from our sweat. I know somebody like Rick, working in the construction is not easy. And I have been there, carrying heavy loads. And somebody like Jim, who works in the army, sometimes you go and work in the desert when the sunshine is 100 degrees, you sweat. And some of the other people, from the sweat, we are to eat from it. So, I want to reflect. This is one piece of the story. The other piece of the story is about the woman who was caught in adultery. When this woman was caught and brought to Jesus by the scribes and the Pharisees who quote the law of Moses that such woman should be stoned. They have judged her guilty and sentenced her to death. Justice is in their hands because the rule is in the hands of the Pharisees. So they brought this woman. They judged her already. They said this woman is sentenced to death. Literally. They will meet out justice with each stone thrown unto them. Because they have said now they want to assemble the stones and then just throw on them. And now, how does Jesus respond when they say they were going to throw stones? When they brought this woman covered because she was caught in the sin and she was just brought there shamefully. Then Jesus said, twice he bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. He did not write with a chalk. The scripture tells us that he wrote with his finger on the earth. And that writing, he says to the crowd, let anyone among you who is without sin be the first to throw the stone on her. Because he was writing on the ground. He did not write with ink. Why? Because that is also the sin. He wrote with the ground, with he dirt his finger in the dirt. What does that reflect? That reflects that Jesus has come and has dipped himself into our dirty life. And when he was writing with the dirt, that symbolizes that when you come to him, even if how dirty you are going to be erased. The sins, your sins are going to be erased. It's not going to be remaining there forever, but he wrote with the dirt. So that symbolizes that our sins will be erased, not delete. There's difference between delete and erase. If you delete, those who are computer literate, if you delete and you go back to the trash, you can still retrieve it. But if you use the eraser, if you write on the chalkboard and you use an eraser and you erase it out, it is done. That is how our sins are erased. They are not going to be there anymore if we accept that we need to be our sins need to be erased. Finally, Jesus bent down when he wrote on the ground and in the dirt, then that is the substances that shows the substances where we were made from. And that marks why it is called Ash Wednesday. Or this is why we celebrate, because we are returning to God. From ash, we will return to God. So in my conclusion, you know that this week is a Valentine day. Valentine week. You can imagine the Valentine week it's coincided with the Holy Wednesday, the Wednesday of the Ash, which symbolizes that we are going to be married to Christ forever. Yes, we are dust, and to the dust we shall return. That is certain. But remember that in Christ Jesus, God our Creator, got his hands dirty with our humility, with our sins, with our failure. We were created from the dust of the earth in order to be transformed by the life-giving breath by love, justice, forgiveness, and grace. Thank you. And as we continue, the next slide is going to be the Holy Communion. And as we go to the Holy Communion, I want to remind you that in the Holy Communion celebration, I'm going to use some of this traditional way of the service. And we will just continue with it. And then when it is about time to give out, then I will invite the stewards to come. But for the first sessions, I will just continue with the liturgy. Then we can just continue. This is the time that we are inviting you, brothers and sisters, to the table. Friends, this is the joyful feast, the power of God. They will come from the east and west, and from the north and south, and sit at the table in the kingdom of God. According to Luke, when our risen Lord was at the table with his disciples, he took the bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them, and then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him. This is the Lord's table. Our Lord invites those who trust in him to share the feast which he has prepared for us. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and our great joy to give you thanks and praise, eternal God and Creator. You have given us life, a second birth in your spirit. Once we were no people, but now we are your people. You claim Israel as your chosen nation and raised up the church as witness to the resurrection, breathing into it your life and power. From worlds apart, you gathered us together when we go astray. You welcome us home. Always your love has been steadfast. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with the choirs of heaven and all the faithfulness of every time and places, who forgive sins, who forever sing to the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and mighty, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are holy, O God, majesty, and blessed is Jesus Christ, your Son and Lord. In love with you and in compassion for all, Jesus healed and taught and challenged and confronted, welcomed and saved. He formed a community, promising to be with his disciples wherever two or three were gathered, and sending them on his mission of hope and healing in the world. Jesus trusted his life to you and went freely to his death so that the world might be set free from suffering and sin. You raised him from the dead and raised us along to live a new life with him. In the power of the Holy Spirit, you sent us out to make disciples, and he commanded, remembering all your might and merciful acts, we take this bread and this blood from the gift you have given us and celebrate with your joy. your joy, the redemption won for us in Jesus Christ. Accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, as a living and a holy offering for ourselves and for our lives, and proclaim the one crucified and risen. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Gracious God, our Father, the Holy Spirit, upon us and upon these, your gift of the bread and wine, that bread and break and cup and blessing, all that you may have the communion of the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. By your Spirit, unite in us your living Christ, and with all who are baptized in his name, that we may be one in the ministry, every place. And as this bread is Christ's body for us, send us out to be the body of Christ in the world. At this time, let me invite the stewards to come forward. Let's join together in our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil. For thine is the kingdom, and power, and glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord Jesus, on the night on which he was arrested, he took bread and after giving thanks to God, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And in the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant, sealed in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink, drink it, and do this in remembrance of me." O God, today you have called us together to be the church. Unite us now at this table and in one loaf and common cup. Make us one in Christ. Body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is given for you, eat in remembrance of Christ. and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is shed for our redemption and our sins. Drink in remembrance that Christ has died for your life. Drink always in his memory. Thank you, stewards.
Stand with me, please.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
Receive your sacrament. Live in the unity of your Holy Spirit. that we may show and go forth with the gifts that God you have given us. And we ask all this through Christ, our Lord, Savior, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for worshiping with us, and we see you on Sunday. Anything else?
Yes. One more song.
Sorry. Please, my apology.
In this time of desperation, when all we know is doubt and fear, there is only one foundation. We believe
Mm-hmm.